the two connections are very different, and they're quite unique in their own way. When I think of the icy lights, I think of balance. That's the first thing that comes to my mind. And how I got inspired originally by that is when I came across this video on YouTube by Ronnie Duncan, this American juggler, contact juggler,
right,
was spinning this crystal sphere on his hands and up his arms, and while he was balancing this sphere on the edge of his fingers. And for me, was, you know, that sphere looked at moments perfectly still, and then it's just capturing that exact moment where the sphere is about to fall, but there's an incredible sense of stability, but at the same time an amazing sense of discipline in this, and it's very graphic. So that's something that really inspired me when I was talking about the connection. And then if I look at the string lights, they're very architectural in the way that they divide the space, in the way they mark the space. And I think of three things, three sentences for me, that three points that capture that. And one is the strings of electricity that connect islands in the landscape as you are on a train and you move along at high speed, and there's an amazing sense of discipline in the way how perfectly parallel these strings of electricity are. And then the second thing is, how do you actually mark your space, especially in an outdoor environment, in a village square when you have a party at night, which put this string of lights in the set in four pylons as posts, marking the space where the party is going to take place. And I wanted to translate that in the interior space, the environment. And then finally, I guess the fact of something very practical is, you want, when you move in a house, you always get the electricity points and the switches at the place where you least want them. So this whole idea about moving them to a more desirable location in a very poetic way. So this is, I think, what captures the connection.
Brilliant. Thank you very much.